In this video, you will learn how to create pop-ups in WordPress without plugins. With this method, you can create two types of pop-ups: sales offer pop-up and a lead generation pop-up with the ability to save leads into a CSV file. Here, the user will be redirected to your URL by clicking on the call to action button. Here, the visitor's email will be stored in a CSV file. The CSV file has three columns: email column, IP column for determining user geolocation, and membership date. This code is written in such a way that the user can easily customize the pop-up to his liking. For example, if you don't need a banner, leave the image variable empty. You can also change the text inside the pop-up and the call to action button here. Let's make these two types of pop-ups together. Go to the link in the description. Copy this PHP code. By clicking on the copy button, this code will be copied on the WordPress dashboard. Go to Appearance, Theme File Editor, and open the functions.php file. As you can see, I am using the Bloxy child theme. You must create a child theme before making any changes to functions.php. Otherwise, the applied changes will be lost after each update. Watch video number 1 on the channel to learn how to make a child theme. Paste the code into the functions.php. First, let's make pop-up type B together. Change the type variable to B. It is better not to show pop-ups more than 4 times per visitor. Also, we want the pop-up to be displayed 5 seconds after the site is loaded. Here I put the link to the banner that I have already uploaded. Enter your desired text here. Write the title of the call to action button here. Put the link to the discounted product here. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, the pop-up will be displayed after 5 seconds, and by clicking on the Shop Now button, you will be redirected to the discounted product page. Now we make a pop-up type A. Change the type variable to A. The rest of the variables are the same as before. Here I put the banner link for lead generation. Write the text inside the pop-up form here. Here you can change the green message that appears after email registration. Change the title of the button to subscribe. Finally, you need to change the name of the CSV file where the leads will be saved. Press Ctrl plus F and search for file name. Change the file name variable here. Please use a complex phrase and a combination of numbers and letters. Anyone who has file name will have access to your subscriber list. Update the file and check the result. Let's register our email twice and check the generated CSV file. To re-register the email, we must delete the browser cookies or use incognito mode. The CSV file of saved emails is stored in the root folder of the website, and its name is the same as the file name variable with the CSV extension. yoursite.com/filename.csv. After downloading the file, check the correctness of the saved information. By default, this pop-up will be displayed on all pages of the site. If you want to display it only on certain pages, you should use conditional tags. For example, by adding 2 ampersands and placing this product tag, this pop-up will only be displayed on the site's products page. We went over conditional tags in depth in video number 7 of the channel. You can find the conditional tags you want by referring to the link in the description of this video. For example, if you want pop-ups to be displayed on hoodie products, copy this piece of code. And paste it here. Now copy the slug related to the hoodies category. And paste it here. Now update the file and go to the shop page. You can see that the pop-ups are displayed on the hoodie page. And they are not displayed on the t-shirt page. That's it! If you do have any questions or comments about this, please put them below. If you liked this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe, and I'll see you next time.